I want to talk about how the spiritual journey is very logical. It's just a big logic. So spiritual journey is logical in the way that, you know, everything is one. So whatever we do will come back to us. If you throw a stone in the pond, all the ripples go out from the stone, but underneath, ripples return to the stone. We just don't see it. So this is what happens in our lives. We don't see a lot of information. So, for example, our culture teaches us to reside in our intellect. And the easiest thing to do is just to go forward with that patterning and receive life from our heads and to be quite out of touch with our bodies. We might not even notice it unless we have particularly a pain or something. But we wouldn't feel the clothes on our skin and our whole body as we're talking, which is how really awake person it's what a really awake person will do. They'll be aware of their body, every part of their body at the same time as they're even deeply engrossed in a conversation. But most of us have not been taught to do that and don't even know that that's possible to live like that. And so what this does, it skews the way our intellect functions, because we're just functioning with part of our intelligence. Yeah, it's quite shocking, and I feel it's almost unpopular to say, and because it's, you know, it makes us a little bit uncomfortable to think that we're off kilter a bit. But, you know, we are. I mean, that's why there's so much mental illness and where we're having so many troubles is we're off kilter. It's like, you know, going back to how what we give out to life is what we get back. So, you know, somebody wise said character is destiny, just because of this, because it all comes back. It's the same principle with, you know, if you want to run a business, a prosperous business, you know, have good business practices, and then your business will last a long time. And if you don't do that, your business won't last as long, and you might get sued. You know, I guess a good business could get sued too, but if they were being ethical, they'd win the case, you know, and the business that was unethical would lose. So this is what happens to us personally in our lives as well. You know, if a personality is, you know, really greedy and exploitive, I mean, basically their days are going to be unpleasant. And at some point in their life, you know, it will start to backfire for them. I mean, it might work for a while, but it will backfire. And even if the backfire is hidden from view, you know, it could be just, you know, in the quality of the family life or all the big screaming match over the will that happens sometimes in families. You know, but it's still there. And the more that an individual's awake to the heart component of themselves, the more they'll be able to see what's really going on. You know, Amma, the famous Indian hugging saint, has a story she talks about that there was this father, and he was a fisherman, and the fish were, you know, he just wasn't doing well. The fish weren't around. Anyway, he'd several days with no food, and the family was starving, and he was walking on the beach, and he passed a sea turtle. And there were 8 eggs, and he took 4 of them. And when he got home, his family asked, why didn't he take them all? You know, and he said, well, Think how sad that he would be if someone came along and took all of his children. And also that if there were no baby sea turtles to become adult sea turtles, there would be no turtle eggs at all for them to eat. That's the big logic, you know? If you take it all eggs, no more sea turtles. It's the bigness of the logic just kind of stares us in the face. The trouble is, when we're out of touch with our hearts, it's like seeing with one eye. We don't, there's a lot of data that we just miss. And when you're really present in your body and you're aware of your experience, as you go through your day, you get a lot of data that you might be too numbed out to get if you're too lodged in the head. And because of that, it makes even our thought processes askew if we're not awake to the dimension of the heart. Our decisions are kind of limited and off, which really I think is why we're having such trouble with our ecology taking care of Mother Earth. Because if we were really in our hearts, we would just have this instinctive reverence for her, and it would be clear what we would do, and we would have the will to do it. It's because we're out of touch with our hearts and out of touch with our bodies, and so we don't realize that if creatures are going extinct, the human race is really threatened, and if Mother Nature's not doing well, no individual is doing well psychologically. We are Mother Nature. We're not separate from her. So if she's having trouble, we're all having trouble. Okay. It's very simple to open your heart. If you're feeling like, oh, what would it be like if my heart was more open? Just do this little experiment. And even sometimes spiritual people, their hearts aren't open. They don't realize it. So you can do this experiment. You say to the universe, pray to Amma or God, the Tao, whatever, and ask that your heart opens as gently and easily as possible in the most supported way. So you get all the support you need, and it's at the pace you can handle. Your heart open. And then and that way you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. And it will be your experience will become your empirical evidence. It's just inarguable. And it's that simple. If you ask that your heart will open, it will open. I promise. I promise. It's how it works. We're heard. We're listened to, we're responded to. It is a loving universe. It's just because we're so stuck in our heads that we don't realize this. Okay. Bless your hearts. Remember, you have a lot of energetic help coming to you all the time. Okay. Blessings.